Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're looking at keyboard and MIDI control over our PD patches. Let's start with the keyboard control. We can use the key object to capture things from our computer keyboard. I'm going to add a number box below it. And this number box, when I press keys on the keyboard, will show the ASCII number for those keys. You notice that it's like press down, up, down, up, down, up. It's always the key down that happens for key. If instead we prefer to get the key up, then we can use the key up object. It works very similarly, except we can go down and then up, down, up, up, down, up, and you can see that they operate one on the key down and one on the key up. We're getting the ASCII value, but we might also want to get the name of the key, which we can use with the key name object. The key name object has two outlets. We're going to use the right outlet in order to get the key name, but the key name is going to be a text string, not a number, so it won't show in the number box. So instead, if you look in the put menu, we're going to use this symbol object. We have used objects, message, number, boxes, and now we're going to use this symbol box. Connect that to the right outlet. When we press our keyboard, we get the number that we're pressing. If we press, say, the delete key, we get backspace with the tab key, arrow keys, left and right, and so forth. So this is the way in which we can capture the keyboard input, I'm going to move it up here, from the computer keyboard. So let's do something with it that makes a noise. We'll create an oscillator object. We use a message box to pass it a pitch value, frequency value. And we're going to use a multiply tilde object as a volume control on the output. And then connect that to the digital to analog converter output. We need to give our amplification a level, and I'm going to change the properties of that to go between 0 and 1, just so I keep the volume within a good range. So if we turn the volume up, we click the 440 message going into the oscillator, we get a 440 tone. There it is, and you can see it on the oscilloscope. All right, so what do we do with our key? So we can use this key control to trigger the pitch. We do that by using a select function in order to select the key value that we want. I know that 97 happens to be key A. So we're going to do that, and that will give us 440. But in terms of getting us an alternative, because we don't know when we might be at something else, we'll create another number box, 660 hertz as an alternative. And I might use the key, what's the next one after that, 115. Okay, so select 115, we get another outlet. That second outlet is going to pass a bang when we get the second number. So now we turn the volume up. If we press S, we get 660. If we press A, we get 440. So it creates a very simple performative interface for triggering aspects of our patch as we go. So that's keyboard control. The other thing which we want to look at today is MIDI control. Now, there are a number of things we need to do before we can start with the MIDI control. The first one is we need to set the preferences. In the media menu or in the PD menu, there's a MIDI settings option. If we open that up, it will allow us to select an input device and an output device for our MIDI control. So these are the MIDI devices that I have currently connected to my computer. I'm going to choose the Novation circuit MIDI controller as my MIDI input, and we're not going to worry about MIDI output for the minute, So I'm just going to say OK. So now we've got a MIDI controller that's connected to PD, and PD is going to listen to it. So let's look at some of the MIDI objects that are available. The kind of most obvious but possibly not the most useful one is simply called MIDI in. It has an output which we can see the numbers which are displayed like so. Now the thing about MIDI is, of course, that it sends three numbers with each MIDI message. So there's a status byte which tells us what type of MIDI message it is. Then there are two additional bytes, and they depend on the status, what they are. But let's say, for example, it's a note, then we might get a note on message. Then we'll get a pitch, like a MIDI number, pitch number message, and then a velocity message. The other most common one is a control message, and we might get the controller number, or the status byte, then the controller number, and then the value. So this MIDI in, when I press my MIDI device, we're getting all of the MIDI data coming in so quickly that it just is a blur in relation to that. What we could do is we can use the print option to make it appear over here on the PD patch. If I do that, I just press a number, you can see that I got a note on status byte, pitch number 31, velocity 96. Then I got a note off status byte, pitch number 31 again, and a velocity of 0 when we turn off. So MIDI in can be useful in one sense, we can get all the data in, but there are some more useful objects which we'll use instead. So if we want to get that note in, we can use the note in object, which has three outlets corresponding to the three MIDI messages. And if I create a number of number boxes, we'll be able to see all of those and connect them up to the three outlets. Then when I play on my MIDI controller, we can see that we get the pitch number, the MIDI note number 31. We get the velocity, if I just press down, that's velocity on 94, and then off is 0 on 100, because I've got a velocity sensitive controller. And the last number is the channel, and in this case my MIDI controller is set to channel 1. So we can see that the output from note in is the pitch number, then the velocity number, and then the channel number. So how can we use this to control our oscillator? Well, quite simply, we know that pitch number, particular MIDI pitches have particular frequencies. PD has a very handy object for us to use for that, and it's called simply MIDI M2F, which stands for MIDI to frequency conversion. So if I pass the MIDI note number into there and then put a note number box afterwards, we'll see that when I press 31, the frequency of that particular note is 48.99 hertz. Compress a different one and we get different numbers depending on the frequency of the notes that I'm selecting. So we can pass that frequency into our oscillator. Oops, let's do that. Turn the volume up and then so as I play my MIDI keyboard, we convert the MIDI note number into the frequency, and then that can control the oscillator. All right, so far so good. The other main kind of MIDI message besides a note message that we'll probably want to use is called a control message. CTL-IN stands for control input. It also has three outlets and they perform similar functions to what they did for note in. So the 1, 2, 3 parts to the MIDI message. When I move my controller on my MIDI controller, I'm going to move a dial. You can see that we've got these numbers changing rapidly. These are the values of that particular dial. This number here, 80, is the controller number. It's controller number 80, and again, 1 is the channel. I've got several dials, controller number 81, controller number 82, controller number 83, and so forth. So this is the value, and as with all MIDI values, it goes from 0 up to 127. On controller number 80. So what could we use our controller for? Well, with our little simple sounding device over here, probably volume would make most sense. But we know that the volume range is from 0 to 1, yet our controller range is from 0 to 127, so we need to scale that. So I can divide the controller range by 127. And if I show the output of that, you'll see that it changes from 0 up to 1. So now we've got the correct range. We can connect that into our volume, and now I can use the controller to turn the volume up and down, and I can change the pitch by notes and change the volume with my controller, and magically we have MIDI control over our PD synthesis process. See you in the next video.